Now, the News 8 Storm Team forecast with meteorologist Matt Ritter.
Another nice day out there. Some high-level clouds starting to stream in our live Lebanon SkyCam. And it is a little more humid today than it was yesterday. But for this time of the year, it still qualifies as comfortable. Mostly sunny, a little warmer today. Still comfortable, though, with highs getting into the low 80s. Yesterday, it got up to 80 degrees even. Mostly sunny and more humid this evening. The humidity really starts creeping up. Temperatures will be in the 70s. And then increasing clouds, feeling kind of sticky overnight tonight. A stray shower possible before the morning rush, and temperatures will be dipping down to 66 to 72, so not as cool as the past couple of nights, but really that was just bonus stuff anyway, because for this time of the year, we really can't complain about the stuff that's on the way for tonight either. 80 in Lancaster and in York, 79 in Harrisburg, Lebanon, Reading, Carlisle, 70 degrees, that's it, in Lewistown at the current time. Dew points are up a little bit into the upper 50s and even some lower 60s. Now that's not oppressive, but it is a little higher than it was the past couple of days. So it's still not too bad out there for this time of the year. Right now, 79 degrees officially, the dew point 59, so that gives us a heat index of 1 degree higher, 80 degrees. Winds are out of the south, a little breezy at 13 miles per hour, pressure just under 30 inches. Big picture showing a few of those high-level clouds are streaming in, a very small complex of dying thunderstorms, which started in Ohio last night, now moving through central West Virginia. High pressure that brought us the unseasonably comfortable weather continues to slide away off the coast. That's going to allow more and more moisture in forms of humidity. This warm front going through tonight could bring us that stray shower. And then the cold front going through tomorrow afternoon will bring us a couple more thunderstorms. And it's also going to have a big steering impact on Hurricane Irene. But for now, there's that front moving through tomorrow afternoon, tomorrow evening with some showers and some thunderstorms. Here's 5 p.m. tomorrow. And that slides on out of here pretty quickly. Sets up a fairly nice day for Friday with high pressure building in overhead then New England. And we start to see in our predictor here, we clearly start to see the hurricane developing. But there's already some spiral bands moving towards the mid-Atlantic, so it may already be raining Friday night, Saturday morning in some of the shore points. But obviously the real serious stuff would still be down around the coastal parts of the Carolinas. Here on the satellite showing the storm growing in size as well as getting a little stronger this morning. The eyes getting a little obscured today by some high-level clouds, but it's starting to move over the Bahamas directly. But in between the islands, still some very warm water, so it does have a chance of strengthening again over the next 24 hours. There are the latest stats, 115 miles per hour, moving to the west-northwest at around 9 miles per hour. And the official track from the National Hurricane Center is kind of an average of a lot of the forecast models. It strengthens it to a Category 4 by about Thursday evening, by about tomorrow evening, as it's departing the Bahamas. Then it takes that turn towards the north. The center, it could be anywhere within this cone. The red line is just an average of probability. It could go any way in here, but as it strengthens, it kind of parallels the coast a little bit. It'd still be a large enough storm to bring some rain and windy conditions to the coastal points. But if it does take a track at this point a little farther to the east, we may not even get any rain out of it. We don't think that's going to happen now, but it's on the table. So the latest forecast for now looks like this. Tomorrow, a little more humid, some scattered showers and storms. Warm but pleasant on Friday. Increasing clouds on Saturday ahead of the hurricane. No matter what, we'll see clouds from the storm, it looks like. And if we're going to get rain out of the storm, it'll be on Sunday, then clearing on Monday. Still a lot of variability in this storm, but it looks like it still could be a serious situation for the coast.
It's going to be a busy few days in the Weather Center.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Matt.